All right, so today I want to take a quick look at this little flight controller here. It's a very early, very pre-production prototype model from Qiotek. See, there's no markings or anything. It's just kind of a little basic plastic case. I'll have a link to Qiotek's website below if you're not familiar with them. They're not a really big name, at least in the United States. I think they do a lot of stuff in China. But they make flight controllers kind of like this one. I've shown this one on the channel before, but I've still yet to actually fly it in anything. But one day we will. We just haven't found the right project for it. They sent me this about a year ago. It's pretty neat, pretty powerful unit, really. But yeah, getting back to this one that we're going to talk about. Like I said, it's pretty inconspicuous, nothing really exciting about it. No markings or anything, just a bunch of connectors and a plastic box. But it's got something pretty interesting inside that we want to kind of bring up and talk about. So bear with me, we're going to open it up real quick. Alright, so like I said, it's got something somewhat unique and exciting inside, that being the microprocessor. As you can see there, it's an F407 chip, which is nothing real spectacular about that. It's 32-bit F4 chip, but if you notice, it's from CKS. It's not the usual ST or STM. So Jason from Qiotek tells me that this, as far as he's aware, as far as we're aware, is the first flight controller in the world using a Chinese stand-in replacement. I don't want to necessarily call it a clone, but it is a pin-compatible and fully functional replacement stand-in for the STM32 chips that are so hard to come by right now, and why other manufacturers, some of them such as like Matek and others, are kind of discontinuing some of their flight controllers. They can't get the chips to run them. So maybe this is the beginning of an end of the chip shortage. Maybe we'll see more flight controllers using chips like this. And it's actually already made it into the hobby. There's a similar chip, if not the same one, is very similar, being used in the T-Lite Jumper V2. Now, I only have the V1. You see mine here is the V1. But the V2 actually uses a CKS chip, just like this one. So maybe we'll start to see this in the future. I don't know, is it a good thing, a bad thing, without maybe getting into the politics and economics of it? Could this be a good thing for the hobby? Bad thing for everything else? I don't know. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think? Maybe we'll see others like Matek start using this stuff and start seeing some prices come back down and more options available in the market. So just a quick little short video while I'm not able to fly, windy and all that good stuff. So we'll get back in the air pretty soon, and I guess I'll see you in those videos. So definitely leave your comments below. I'd like to know your thoughts.